guys, I'm excited and thrilled to hang out with this young lady right here, especially because of the genre of music she's into. Don't forget, it's still GhanaMusic.com, and I'm your host, Miss Deka. Sister Ifya, how are you?
I'm good, sweetie. How are you?
I'm great. How is Ghana treating you?
Oh, great, great, great. It's always great to come back home and just experience the whole sunset and the whole vibe and everything. So it's great.
Okay, so Sister Fiat, GhanaMusic.com fans who really don't know you, can you introduce yourself or tell us a bit about yourself?
Okay, so I'm a young lady, obviously, and I'm a high life artist. Sister Fiat doing, you know, contemporary high life. So watch out for my new singles, which is about to drop very, very soon. So yeah.
Okay, so Sister Fia, your debut single, Kokrono, you wrote it yourself?
No, I didn't write the song. It was Kader's idea and everything, so he composed the whole thingy.
Okay, so I want to know the inspiration behind the song.
You know, when me and Kader was in the studio and he brought up this kind of concept of a song, I was like, you know what? It's actually true, because then love is not being treated right these days, like this kind of modern, you know, days. And he made sense with the song, so he made it so perfect. So that's why I came up with Kokrono, because I understood what he was trying to say.
So Sister Fia, you have a new single out, which is Are You Ready? It was produced by Bisa Kade and written by him. I want to know, are you joining the gang of musicians who prefer to have ghostwriters as to composing the songs themselves?
No, I am not joining the gang of ghostwriters. I can write songs, but then I'm not going to say I'm perfect. I'm still getting there, because I started to do this writing. This writing is new to me, but I'm not joining the gang of ghostwriters. I can write songs if I just really sit down and concentrate on a particular genre of a song I'm trying to do. So I could do anything, really.
So what is the connection between you and Bisa Kade? How did you guys come about? How did you guys meet?
Kade is like, he's like my brother. He's like my everything, basically. Everything as in everything. He helps me out with a lot of things. I actually classify him as a person who's really good to me. And we came about in London. We met in Wembley, and then my manager was the one who introduced me to him. So he told me to come over to sing for him. So I sang for him. He was like, oh yeah, you're really good, you know, we can work something out. So that's how me and Kade came up. We were like brothers. We care for each other. Yeah, I'll just fight for him, basically.
So contemporary high life is the genre you're into. Is that what you really want to do, or are you banking on it? Because a lot of females are not into contemporary high life.
That's a great question. One thing I've always been around contemporary high life music, because my mom is a singer, my dad is a high life king. He presumes himself as to be. And high life has just been in my childhood since I was a kid. I was always singing, you know, I'm actually did this song when I was with my mom. So then when Kade came to me and said, you know what, you've got a high life tone, so let's actually brand you as a high life person. I'm like, yeah, that's actually true, because he took the word straight out from my mouth, because I wanted to be a high life singer. So then he gave me the song and I sang it, and he was like, perfect. You are just perfect when it comes to high life. And I did offer, you know, genre of songs, and he was like, oh, I think I'll go for high life with you. So that's how the high life thing came about.
All right, great. So aside Bisa Kade, you've mentioned artists you'd want to collaborate with. You mentioned the likes of EL, Khaki, etc., etc. Are there any other people in mind aside these people?
You know what? I can't say this, but you know, I got a crush on EL. I'm just kidding. Anyway, I haven't got a crush on him, but I kind of get a crush on him.
You have a crush on EL. You just said it. Don't take it back. Okay.
Really?
So let's get to the part where other people you'd want to collaborate with.
I want to collaborate with Kwabena, he's amazing. Dasibrit Jamina, he's amazing. And who else? Becca, she's great. Ifya, she's amazing. I want to collaborate to all the musicians, I would. I want to collaborate to everybody, basically.
That's great. For a 24-year-old girl, let me just go there, you have such strong stand on love. Because I read your Facebook page and I'm like, whoa, what is she talking about? I mean, tell us about love in general.
Love is beautiful, baby. Love is just a gorgeous thing. A lot of people doesn't experience. Look, I have experienced love before, and it was in a good sense. So I'm using that as an experience to move on you know, talk about love, let people know how beautiful love is, and just don't, they don't, people see the bad side of love these days. So I just want to talk about love. That's what I just want to see the right side of love. That's why I'm always talking about love, seriously.
So people see your appearance or your dressing, honestly, your apparels as provocative. Is it part of the brand, Sister Ifya? Is it part of the brand?
Oh my days, look, dressing is not a problem for me. It's not my brand, it's how I feel. It's anytime I want to dress, I want to put a clothes on, it's how I feel at that particular moment. I don't really think of what people might think of me. I just want to embrace myself in whatever I wear. If your boobs are cute and you want to wear cut-through dresses, it's up to you. If your hands are beautiful and you want to wear short sleeves, it's up to you. So that's why I always say, embrace yourself, baby.
So in summarization, we're going to see more of the boobs.
No,
a whole lot.
Not every time. Sometimes you have to actually close them, you know, make it personal.
So you spoke about the fact that a lot of female artists in GH don't have a voice in the industry. You did say that. What came about? Why did you say that?
It's obvious. It's obvious. You know, you don't. I don't remember last time a female artist won Artist of the Year. Do you remember that? I'm always, you know, checking Ghana news and everything. I don't remember the last time a female won Artist of the Year. I'm not saying the female are not doing good. They are doing good, but then the industry. I'm new, so I can talk a little bit more about that. But all I just want to say is, people need to recognize the women in the industry because they are really trying hard. Becca is trying hard. Ifya is trying hard. Wayala, is it?
Wayala.
Wayala, she's amazing. My mom is a massive fan of her, honestly. And every girl in the industry is trying, so they should actually give chances to the ladies.
All right, Sister Ifya, let's talk about record labels. You're with Streamline Music, co-signed to be Sakade on Black Legendary Music.
Yes.
I'm right?
Yes, you're right.
Okay, so tell me the connection between the two.
Oh, so it's a co-sign thing. So it's two people coming together to join one and produce me, as in they believe in me. So that's why they are helping me out.
Let's lighten up the mood here. A picture of you went viral on Instagram. Yourself and Too Sweet Anan. Everybody wants to know, are you dating?
We just care for each other.
You care for each other?
Yes. Mm-hmm.
You care for each other? Is that what you said?
Yes, we care for each other.
You know each other personally?
Of course.
Of course.
Yeah.
All right, so there must be something going on. Care for each other is strong, right?
I didn't say we've got anything going on.
But you care for each other.
You can care. I can care for my sister, so I can tell you I care for my sister. So I care for my mom. It's the same thing. I care for Too Sweet.
It's agape love, like Ghanaians call it.
You just said it. I didn't say anything.
You have a new single out called Are You Ready? And it was also written and produced by Bisakade. Are you joining the gang of musicians who prefer ghostwriters as to composing the songs themselves?
Ooh, I don't know. Kade is just a massive songwriter. He's the best, you know. You don't know. I call him a wizard because he's so great in writing lyrics and producing sounds. But anyway, Are You Ready? Came up about a movie I watched over time, and I was talking about this movie to him, and he was like, you know what, it's actually true. Obe Warren Mia, now, you know, he just brought the lyrics coming up, and I'm like, you know what, we could actually use this as a song. And we came up with Are You Ready? So nothing else.
Ghana Music Awards is coming up soon. I'm sure you have a favorite in there. Who do you think are likely to be in the nominees of Artist of the Year?
Mansai, of course, Bisakade, 100%, no doubt. And Shatawale, obviously, he's been great this year. And this guy, Eki Kimi.
Okay, that's Wiser.
Wiser. And who else? Yeokum. All these hit songs this year, I just hope all of them come. I think they're just going to be in the Ghana Music Awards.
Okay, so if you were to pick one person, your ultimate choice, who would it be?
Straight up and down, Bisakade.
All right, it was obvious. I saw it coming. So your final words, Sister Ifya, anything you want to say to fans who relate to you, especially on social media, anything about your music, tell us about it. Final words.
So this is Sister Ifya again. Watch out for me. Finally, there's a High Life female artist. I know people have been waiting for that for years, so I'm finally here, so expect great from me. And I just want to say a massive thanks to all my fans who has been pushing my song, encouraging me, giving me all that benefit of doubt. And finally, I just want to say shout out to my manager, who is the greatest manager in the world, Black Legendary Music, Bisakeda, has been supportive, and my mom, she's just amazing. And yeah, basically everybody, even you guys.
Thank you very much. It's been, I've had loads of fun hanging out with you. It's been great. This interview has been, sorry, I remember, yeah, slow down before. I must say this interview has been great and informative as well. And I've gotten to know Sister Fia very well. But don't forget to follow us on Instagram, Twitter, like our Facebook pages, and subscribe to our YouTube channels, allghanamusic.com. Till then, I still remain yours truly, Miss Decca. I'm out.